When we talk about picking blockchains, open public versus decentralized, open public decentralized versus more private and, well, more centralized versions, it's a game of trade-offs. As we've mentioned before, it is basically open, global, decentralized, immutable for the commons or blockchains as a common, where everybody can use it for free and where innovation is open sourced, etc., versus more of a commercialized or government type versus the business as a business as usual, but just more of a incremental type of innovation where open and blockchains, open public blockchains offer radical innovation. And we will discuss in level three where what these types of innovation mean and how you can manage that as a human or as an entity, as a corporation, blah, 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 blah. We go from there, walk with me. Let me grab a pink one, whatever it is. So we've got three types of properties when we talk about ledgers. We've got decentralized, secure, scalable. As mentioned before, it's just as being a consultant, it's either cheap, high quality, or fast. You can't have all three of them. So you're either very fast, but not very good in the quality and cheap department, or you are very cheap, but not very good in the quality, blah, blah. You know where I'm going, right? So in best, you have two out of three, and perhaps a bit of three. But every time you shift towards a more lower version, you shift from one of these balloons towards a more specialized version, which isn't always a problem. It all depends on your use case. So in the case of Bitcoin, for example, it's more important that you are secure currently than that you are scalable. And as soon as you're start talking about more scalability, so other development, like for example, the Lightning Network, the exact same properties apply because these are inherent. It's just a trade-off. You can't just have all three of them. So yes, we move more towards a scalable version of Bitcoin in the second layer. We will explain later on how that works. But in this case, you move more towards the scalable spectrum. So scalability moves up, but we move away from decentralization. So it's getting more centralized and less secure. So the aim, some people say that we should aim here. And they call that spot the sweet spot, where you have decentralization, security, and scalability all in one. Of course, this all depends on the use case. I can imagine for Bitcoin, for example, that security, scalability, and decentralization is this sweet spot is perfectly fine when we talk about paying a croissant. It needs to be fast. It needs to be decentralized. I don't want anybody to see my data. And I need it to be secure. But if we're talking about selling houses or selling huge amounts of money, I prefer it to be secure other than being scalable. I don't mind waiting for 10 or 20 minutes or for 40 or 60 minutes or how long. I don't mind even waiting for a day, as long as I'm absolutely sure that my transaction is secure and that I received the money and that the payment is final, so we can't reverse it. So that I don't sign away my house and later on I heard, hey, you didn't receive the money and the buyer of your house won't sell it back because you now gave him the deeds of your house. So this all depends on the use case as well. So the Lightning Network is perfectly fine, but remember, you sacrifice a bit of decentralization and a bit of security, which is fine, of course, because the Lightning Network is meant for smaller payments. If you want to have more security, it's inherent, it's logical that you will need to wait a bit longer. And this is called the scaling trilemma. And so far, there hasn't been a solution. The question is whether will there ever be a solution, just like the Byzantine general problem isn't solved. This problem can't be solved as well, because it's just a trade-off. Of course, that doesn't mean that there are practical approaches, just as Satoshi proved with the Byzantine general problem, and that the Lightning Network might prove regarding this problem. But remember, practical solutions and always moving in this spectra. So if you ever read about a blockchain that can do a gazillion transactions in a decentralized way without offering any scalability or decentralization, it's either a scam or the designers have no idea what they're talking about. You can pick whatever you prefer, but both a very dangerous situation, of course. So for now, we've did a quick recap of ledger technology. Next session is a very interesting one where we will discuss, of course, all the sessions are very interesting, but next session will be a very interesting one where we will explain the different properties you can tweak to move in this spectrum. So if I tweak, for example, the block size, so create bigger blocks, I tweak in cryptography, and then I will go towards more scalability if we have bigger blocks, but less decentralization. And I could do many, many other tweaks of other variables, and we will present you an overview of these variables in a structured manner called the crypto flower. I wish my team good luck drawing that flower. I'm not allowed to draw, by the way. I'm a terrible, terrible drawer, which I will prove in the future, but not next time. So see you there.